Baby, this year it's just gonna be you and me. Hang by the fire and chill. Isn't this how it's supposed to be? Making our Christmas memories. Oh, and I've been longing to hold you close. Forget about everyone else. Isn't this how it's supposed to be? Making our Christmas memories.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm so excited to finally share my Christmas home decor tour. I've been working on this for several weeks, getting my home all decorated and festive and cozy, so I hope that you really enjoy this. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you like this type of content, please let me know in the comments down below. If you are new to my channel, I make a lot of lifestyle content here on my blog, modernmolly.com. I hope that you will consider subscribing. Without further ado, let's get into the video.
Whoa, oh, oh. Making our Christmas memories.
This is our coffee bar slash hot chocolate bar. It is a little over the top for me, definitely more than I normally would decorate this space, but there were just so many things that I wanted to include. I wanted to make it feel really cozy and festive and feel like you could make a delicious cup of hot chocolate here. So I have all that plus all of our coffee supplies. Also within the past year, we got an espresso maker and we were going to get rid of our Keurig, but we just haven't yet because we still use it all the time. So it's a little bit overcrowded here right now, but we use everything, so that's what matters. And let's go through all of the items. So up on this ledge, I just have one of the reusable Starbucks cups for one of their red cup days. I think it was 2 or 3 years ago. And then I have this cute little sign that was from Michael's last year. If they do have that and any of the other decorations available online, I'll definitely link them in the description box. This is our espresso maker, our pride and joy. We love it. It is from Breville. It is the Bambino, and it is such a great compact little machine. You can either do a single shot or a double shot. And then it also comes with a steam wand and a little milk frother container. I forgot what that's called. And yeah, it's been really good. We've been enjoying learning more about making fun coffee drinks, and we can also steam up milk for hot chocolates or to put in tea or whatever we want. So that's been a great tool. Over here, we just have this tray stand that is from HomeGoods or TJ Maxx. I had another tray that had a similar design for fall, but I wanted one that was a little bit bigger for all of the Christmas items. Then I have a few different hot chocolate supplies. I have this chocolate hazelnut flavored syrup. This is from Tarani. I got this at World Market. I also have this cocoa cinnamon sugar blend from Trader Joe's that came in a pack with some other spices. I have this hot chocolate that came from Nordstrom, and then I have the snowman hot chocolate that came from Trader Joe's. These have been so popular over the past few years. It's basically, I don't know if they invented the hot chocolate bomb, but it definitely came out before the big hot chocolate bomb phrase and a basic craze. And it basically has white chocolate, and then inside it has milk chocolate chips and mini marshmallows. So that's a fun little activity. And then this canister, I wanted to find like a little cup, but I don't have one right now. So I'm just using this that already has tea bags in it. And then I got these really adorable little spoons for hot chocolate. I got these from Anthropologie recently, so I'll definitely link them. And I've been wanting little spoons for hot chocolate because there's always cocoa and things at the bottom of the mug, and I just want to be able to mix them back in. So I was like, these are perfect when I found them. And then finally, this little sign that says warm up at the hot chocolate bar came from Michael's last year. It was in the same line as this little sign. Down below, I have this little mini marshmallows container, which right now I just have a couple hot chocolate packets, like single packets of this brand. These are from World Market. And then over here I have these marshmallow toppers. These are so good. They're from Costco. They are marshmallows with dark chocolate and then caramel sauce and I think sea salt on top.
They're so delicious. Also, I did make my own marshmallows. I didn't have a place to put them, but I did homemade marshmallows. If you're interested in like a baking video for Christmas, learning how to make marshmallows, definitely let me know. I'd be happy to do something like that, but only if you're interested. And back here, I have my milk frother, which now that I have the steamer, I don't really use it very much, but occasionally I do if I have like a flavored creamer that I'm gonna have with coffee from the Keurig. Finally, the Keurig that is still going strong. We got this in summer 2015, so we've had this for quite a while and it's really stood the test of time. I think it's the Keurig 2.0. And I just have this peppermint mocha mug sitting down here. This is from Ray Dunn. I have a few other festive mugs, but it was already so crowded on this space that I didn't want to make it worse. So I just have one out. So that's everything for the coffee bar, hot chocolate bar decorations. Now let's move on to the living room.
I've been working so much lately, I can barely find the time to sleep. Yeah, I spend my time running around, keeping people pleased. But this is my favorite holiday. It's a chance to start over new. Cause I missed you so I'm letting go of everything but you. These are the good times with you.
The living room is really the star of the show and I absolutely love how we decorated. It feels so festive and cozy and I just want to be in this space. So really loving it, excited to walk you through everything. Below our TV, we have a fireplace. This was a gift from my parents a few years ago. It's a portable fireplace. It is great. I love that I can turn the heat off if I want because it does get pretty warm in California and I can just have the cozy looking fire on. And then right below the fire, I put a couple different lanterns. I got these last year from Michael's and I had them outside our front door, but we weren't really getting to see them or use them. So I moved them inside this year and I like this a lot better. I have flameless candles that are set on a timer so they just go off. And I think this looks so good. I also have this garland. This was, I believe, from Home Depot a few years ago, and it just fits nicely over the fireplace. And then we have our stockings. These are actually from Target a few years ago. And this year I wanted to change it up from the red letters, so I got these gold ornaments, and I think they look really good. I just used a safety pin underneath and hung these up. And these look really good, although I wish I had another string so that it was a little bit more even, but honestly, it's okay. I love the look of it, and I like that we used what we had and then just kind of made something new with it. Of course, because nutmeg stocking is really little, it doesn't quite work as well, and I added her first little present in here yesterday, so it's a little bit lopsided. We got her a little catnip gingerbread person, and I still think it looks really cute. I don't mind that it's not perfect. It's ours, and it's cozy. This reindeer I got last year from Michael's, it ended up being a little bit bigger than I thought it would be, so I just have it next to the TV. Here is my beautiful tree. We have had this tree for a few years. We got it the year we got married, which is 2017. This tree came from Walmart. It is a 7.5 foot flocked tree. And it was fairly affordable. The year that we got it, the only thing I picked up was this star, which is from Target, and then all of the ornaments. These ornaments came from Michael's, Home Goods, and Walmart. Over the last few years, I've gotten these beautiful picks from Michael's. The flowers I got last year, and I believe they're still available. Gold feathers I got from Michael's probably 2 years ago at this point. And then we have a few just special ornaments as well. Engraved wood key ornament, and this came from Etsy. This was for our first year in our house, 2019. We also have this Just Married from my in-laws. We also have some of these gold ornaments from them as well. I believe these were from Crate and Barrel. We also have the pickle ornament from my in-laws. If you know what the pickle ornament means, leave a comment. And I think that's everything for the tree. I mostly did silver, gold, rose gold, kind of mixed metals, things that I felt were like a little bit more elegant and metallic, and just really fun, sparkly, bright tree. So that is everything. Oh, and the tree skirt. I can't remember where that's from. I feel like it was either from Target, Michael's, or Walmart, one of the three, but that is super old. And that is that. I love this tree, but I will say the flocking is very messy, and Joe was definitely leaning towards replacing this tree next year. Here is what we have going on in the bookcase. I tried to use what we already had and then incorporate some fun Christmas decorations. First up, this sign I believe was from Michael's last year. I really like that it's like a winter wonderland setting and the 3D effect is really cool. This stack of books I believe was either from Michael's or Target, and I think it was also from last year. I really love the look of the stacked books. I think it's really cute. And then finally, I have this forest grade tree. It's a wood tree and I got it from the Bullseye Playground this year. And here's an item that I already keep on the bookcase regularly, and it is technically a terrarium that I got from Amazon, and I have all of our wedding cards in it. Moving down to the second shelf, I have a Christmas candle, and then I have another sign, which I think is either from Michael's or HomeGoods. And then I have this beautiful gold reindeer from Kirkland's. They had a couple different sizes or different positions. One was standing, one was sitting, I believe. And then we have our wedding book. If we move down, then we have our guest book from our wedding along with a menorah. And this box is from Target last year from the Sugar Paper. They do a bunch of different holiday wrapping, and I like to pick up the gift boxes and just use them around my house throughout the year. And then finally, on the last shelf, we have this photo from our wedding, and then we have a ginger jar, and I tied a gold bow around it, and then this L was actually from, I think it was from either my bridal shower or from our wedding couples table. We just got this new mirror. We literally got it yesterday. I'm so excited about it. It goes between our two windows in our living room, and I feel like this space really needed something, and this adds a lot of light to the room, and we have two other mirrors, so it just kind of complements it. Didn't do a whole lot with our couch. We're actually getting a new couch. It's been almost 5 months since we ordered it, and it's supposed to come right after Christmas. So very excited. So I'm just using a few different pillows that I picked up for the new couch. It's gonna be a little bit bigger, so I got a couple big pillows that are very neutral and will go well with that couch, and they are from Target. I got them very recently. This pillow in the front is also pretty neutral. I really like the little pom-poms on the Christmas tree, and that came from Kirkland's this year. The blue pillow back there that is monogrammed, it was an engagement gift, so it was from years ago from Ralph Lauren. And I have a blanket back here that my cousin crocheted last year for me for Christmas. And this couch is from, ooh, where is it from? Oh, this couch is from Living Spaces, and we got it when we moved into our old apartment in San Jose, so we've had it for a few years, and we are definitely ready for it. I also wanted you to see what everything looks like at night. This is with the overhead light, and this is with the overhead lights off. How magical is this?
Baby, this year it's just gonna be you and me. Hang by the fire and chill. Isn't this how it's supposed to be? Making a Christmas
going
memory.
On the kitchen counter, I have this beautiful advent calendar that came from Target this year. This is from the Hearth and Hand line, and I was eyeing this one last year. I think they've had it for a few years, but it sold out very quickly. So I was excited to get my hands on it, and I think it looks perfect over this corner. I also have a tiered tray that has little signs. Most of these I got last year. That was my first year doing a tiered tray. They're little ornaments and bottle brush trees that I think it looks really cute. This little tree came from the Target Bullseye Playground a few years ago, and this cookie jar is also from Target, from the Bullseye Playground, and I believe it was from last year. This is the situation I have going on in my office. For the first time ever, I bought a Christmas tree for my home office. I picked up this pencil tree from Michael's a few weeks ago, and I love how it fits so well in this space because it's so narrow, but it's still 7 feet tall. I wanted to get a few things to fill up the tree, so I got these really pretty glittery, shimmery faux flowers from Michael's. And I also added some bows that I already had from Target a few years ago. These were from the Wonder Shop. And I added a really beautiful star from Crate & Barrel. It has a little switch on the back to turn it on. And then I have several different ornaments left over from our tree, including some of these really pretty stars that we didn't get a chance to use, and lots of fun metallic balls. The only other decorations I have are over here in my closet. I have a couple of these little fun houses from Target. I love this little pink one, and then this white one just complements it so well, I had to do it. So that's everything in my office. Let's go and head downstairs and check out the dining table and the bar card.
And I've been hold you close, forget about everyone else. Isn't this how it's supposed to be? Making our Christmas memories.
Our table is set up really simply, and honestly, I think I'm going to keep it this way. I got this centerpiece this year from Target, and I think it's absolutely beautiful. I got these candles from World Market. This is another Christmas candle, and then this I've had for years. And then I just have our salt and pepper shakers and a napkin holder, and then this table runner. I also wanted to share the advent calendars I picked up for this year. So this one is from See's Chocolate, and I believe this is their first year doing an advent calendar. Very excited for that one. And this one is from David's Teas, and it's a caffeine-free tea calendar. I haven't seen this from them before, although I will say I haven't looked in the past couple years. I don't do like a lot of caffeine, so this is perfect for me. And I think this is such a stunning calendar. Let me just open it. So each day you get a little container of loose leaf tea, and it's supposed to make 1 to 2 cups of tea. So Joe and I can share this. Isn't this so beautiful? We're going to end with probably my favorite like surprise area. I wasn't expecting to really do much with the bar cart, but I totally cleaned it off. I changed up the decor. I made this beautiful dried orange garland, and I'm really happy. So let's walk through. The first thing I did was decant some of my alcohol. I found these really beautiful decanters from the Target Bullseye Playground this year. They were only $5 each. I used the little stickers that were on the bottom of the product and just marked what the different types of alcohol were. And I even have one left over for something else in the future. Here's another one of these little beaded wood trays, and I put a few cocktail essentials. I have a hot toddy mix. That's Joe's. He loves hot toddies. And then I have a few different types of bitters. And then I have this little bottle opener thing that says cheers. And I just think this looks so cute together. I have my shaker and then a couple different types of alcohol and syrups and things like that. And then I have these beautiful cocktail glasses. These are from Anthropology. I got them either this year or last year. And I love these for a fun cocktail. And I also have these fun glasses for wine that my friend gave me last year for Christmas. Over here, I have a bit of decor. I have this little sign that says cocktails. I have this Nest holiday candle. I have this glass Christmas tree with the gold base. That's from Target. And then this sign, I believe it was from Target at some point. I thought that we needed something else in this corner, so I added that. And then finally, I just have my faux fiddle leaf fig. I've had this for ages. Normally it's next to the bookcase, but with the Christmas stuff, there's not really room. Here is the garland. I dried some oranges. I'll put in the description box how I did that. I actually followed a tutorial on Instagram. And then I got this really pretty garland with beads from Target from the Wonder Spot or Wonder Shop. And then I just connected these with zip ties. I actually hadn't trimmed them, so in the last clip you may have seen the edge of the zip tie. But it's working really well so far. I think this is really fun and pretty. I will say it took a long time to dry the oranges, and you definitely want to cut them to an even thickness so that they dehydrate at the same rate. But otherwise, I think it looks really fun, festive, and something different for me. And then finally with our cart, we have our glasses, we have bottles of wine and champagne, Moscow Mule mugs, then we have little bottles of alcohol and all kinds of cocktail accessories in here. We also have this mirror that we have had for quite a while now, and I think it's a really nice addition to this area. All right, so that is everything for the bar, and actually this concludes my tour. That is everything for my Christmas decor tour. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope it gave you some inspiration, and I hope that you have a really wonderful holiday season. Again, if you are not subscribed to my channel, I hope that you will consider subscribing. And if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments down below how you're decorating for the holiday season, and I'll see you next time. Bye.